behind. No, not yet. But we're gonna have you guys line up.
What's this?
Behind the coach that'll be holding your country's flag.
Oh, oh, oh. Hey, guys,
to look up past Olympians from 2008 swim team.
No, but I can
lose that. Well, there's more opportunities today to get spirit points, luckily. And a lot of today will be about competition, as we will be handing out our medals today. So that's something to look forward to. And just a quick overview of what we'll be doing today. First, Coach K will be leading you guys through treading water, and this will be the last thing that you guys will be learning. And then after that, we'll be reviewing all the strokes. And then from there, we'll go into the gliding competition and then a medley relay. And then for the final competition, you guys will get to choose which stroke you want to swim. And then the final thing is the closing ceremonies. And so that's something that you guys can look forward to, and it can help motivate you during your competition. And overall, though, we want you to take ownership of the cues that we've given you and integrate these into your strokes, which is, so this is a major focus of today. And with that, I'll hand things over to Coach K.
Okay, so everybody go ahead, grab your goggles, whatever you need. If you want to leave your shirts on, that's fine. We're going to go ahead and sit down on the deep end of the pool first, okay? So go ahead and meet me, you guys can meet me down there.
Sure.
Close your eyes, Okay, we're going to imagine a couple of different situations real fast. Okay. So, you're in an elevator, and the doors are two-thirds of the way shut, right? So there's a little space. Now, if you're going to open the elevator, okay, I want you to think about how you would open that elevator, okay? And then likewise, just like today, it's a sunny day, you're sitting inside on the couch, and you have blinds in front of your window, and they're open. And so how would you go about closing them? Okay? Good, okay, so now I want you guys to go ahead and open your eyes. Okay, now I want you guys to pay attention to Sarah, keep doing that. Okay, Sarah, how she's making circles with her feet, okay? Now, that's what we're gonna be doing with our feet. That's called egg beating, okay? Except the only difference is one leg is gonna be going counterclockwise while the other leg is gonna be going clockwise, okay? And the idea with opening the elevator was I wanted you guys to imagine yourselves reaching in and pulling out, right? So you're gonna open the elevator and then you're gonna close the blinds. So you're making figure eights with both your hands in front of you, okay? And your hands are gonna be, make sure they're facing down at all times, but your hands when you're going out are facing out. When your hands are facing in, or when you're coming in, your hands are facing in. And as you can see, Coach Wingy, she's doing the figure eights here with her hands, okay? As well as Coach Lisa, she's doing the egg beaters as well. Okay, and so if what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and have you guys jump in the pool. We're going to give you guys a couple minutes to go ahead and try and practice this, okay? If at any point you feel uncomfortable, you feel free to go ahead and grab onto the wall. We're trying to avoid you grabbing the lane lines, if I'm not mistaken. And so if there's people on the inner lanes that need to use the wall, you guys can move into the middle, okay? So first we'll go ahead and start on the wall, get your legs doing the egg beaters, okay? And then we're going to try and come off the wall and use our hands, okay? So go ahead and jump in the pool. Shot.
Oh, it's so cool.
So, guys, one more thing. Up, eyes up here, okay? So you're doing this with your legs are going like equal and opposite, right? The legs should never hit in the middle. They should be spread out far enough. You can just sit and do this in the water. And you can go either direction, whatever's the most comfortable for you. Okay? And then another option, if the egg beaters aren't working for you, make sure I don't fall in the pool. Okay? It's similar to a scissor kick or the flutter kick, okay? So what you're gonna do is you bring knees up and you can just do this back and forth, long, slow. We gotta make sure they're continuous movements with everything you do for treading water. Okay? And this is great, really good for, like Coach Moore said, if you end up for some reason stuck in the middle of the ocean, saving your energy, okay, and floating. Treading water to stay above water.
You'll get tired.
Yeah. Does anybody having trouble with the egg beaters? Okay, imagine if you try, imagine sitting on the side of the pool, right? You're just kind of letting your legs,
Is that egg beater feeling like a basket? Yeah, but if you're like, is that natural?
Is that natural? Try beating with your knees.
Okay, so
it's just like your head. Wherever your head goes, your body will follow. Wherever your knee goes, your foot will follow. No, you can go either way. You just want one leg going counterclockwise, one leg going clockwise. Opposite, exactly. But your knees are bent. Make sure you guys have your knees bent.
Caitlin, you're trying to do egg beater? Just imagine making circles with your toes. There you go. I'll try to just come off the wall a little bit and incorporate your arms. Just stay up.
Hey, skip it.
Use your arms. You're not using your arms. There you go.
Sarah, how's it feeling to you?
Did you kind of understand that they're going opposite directions?
Yeah. But I don't feel like how that. That's right. The other one's better.
Okay. Alright guys, back, eyes up here. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and take it down to the other end of the pool. Okay, so whatever stroke you feel the most comfortable with, we're gonna use that on the way back. Okay? So go ahead and head down that direction.
Let's go.
Freestyle, and one of the things, like Lisa said, we want you guys to take responsibility for the cues that we've used. So this is one of the first strokes that we taught you, and I want you guys to kind of, you know, rattle out some of the cues that we gave you for the arm stroke and for the flutter kick. So if you guys, you know, anybody?
Spear the fish.
Boiling water.
So boiling the water.
Spear the fish.
Spear the fish. Reach for the cookie.
Pull out the gun.
Question mark stroke.
Pull out the gun.
Pull the gun out of the holster.
Chicken wing.
What's another way of the chicken wing?
Puppet.
Arm on a string.
Nice. Look in the window.
Oh yeah, look in the window. Nice.
Oh, breathe is the arc.
Where are you looking when you're not breathing? Where are you looking during the stroke?
Straight down.
Okay, we're gonna use a demonstrator. We want Mike, somebody that we've noticed that's, you know, very good at at freestyle form. If you could just show us. Show us your freestyle. Everyone just keep your eyes on Mike.
Just halfway back. Just halfway back.
Whoa. Nice job, Mike.
So we want you guys to practice the freestyle and just show us your best form. Okay? So we'll have a couple minutes of practice. We're only going halfway.
Halfway.
Early to the song.
I swam over here. I had to switch mid half one. Mid strokes, my legs were just.
Oh no.
Thank you.
track of a count. Okay, so you're going to count to four. Right, so you take a breath. One, two, four, and then you breathe. That way you know when your next breath is.
So, what? Just real quick, what's your favorite cue? What's the one thing that you have going through your head the entire stroke that helps you the most? Spear the fish. Any other ones?
R. Breathing a lot.
Reach for the cookie.
Reach for the cookie.
Puppet.
Puppet, arm on a string. Good job, guys. You guys, honestly, you're a lot better with the freestyle form coming from the very first day to today. So I just want to let you guys know that we're really impressed with your form. So I'm going to pass it off to Lisa, and we're going to move on to the backstroke.
All right. So can someone tell me something they remember about your core concerning the backstroke?
Belly button.
On a string.
Yes, exactly. And anything about a rod?
A rod through your body?
A rod through your back?
Back, body?
Yes. Yes. And then, how should your face be?
Back. Got a pillow.
Yep. Facing the sky. And then, what should your legs be doing?
Boil in the water.
Ankles loose.
Ankles loose. And how should your knees be?
A little bent.
Exactly. And lastly, for your arms, what are some cues for your arms?
Make the rainbow.
Oh,
that's right.
Yep.
See you later.
Yeah.
Thumbs up.
Yep. Exactly. And one more thing to mention before you guys practice is that one thing you should try and focus on is bring your shoulder up to your chin, which will help you when you do your arm movement. Any questions before you guys start? All right, you guys can go ahead and swim to the halfway mark.
All right, Australia.
It's so good.
Okay.
And well, let's go, China. Nice job, Kaylin.
Yeah, I really, really like how you keep your head back.
Yeah.
Yeah, more bubbling.
Yeah. You're good.
It like comes into the dark, and I'm like, oh, is that the shadow of the wall? Is that the shadow of the wall?
Lisa?
Nice job.
All right, good. So I'm going to go ahead. We're going to review the breaststroke. Okay, so before we get started, do you guys remember some of the cues that we had you guys try to remember?
Inverted hearts or backwards
heart. 5 gallon bucket.
Yeah. What?
Ice cream.
Inverted
heart.
Inverted heart. Okay, so what do you do with the ice cream?
Scoop it.
And straight to the mouth. Okay, what about for the legs? Those are all arms that we've gotten so far.
Load and lock.
Any other ones for the legs? What are your knees doing?
Good.
What about the feet?
Dorsiflex.
Good. And the power V, right? And you're going to draw circles with your feet, right? Okay, good. So once again, we want to make sure you guys make these cues your own so that they'll help you guys to remember, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to have Nate, he's going to go ahead and demonstrate for us.
Yeah, Nate.
Remember you guys have a lot of trouble with the timing, so I want you guys to watch the timing of the kick, glide, and stroke, too, okay? Go ahead, Nate. Thanks, bud. Good. So you guys, if you notice, when he comes out of the water, that's when his legs are coming back to his glutes. Okay, and so then that way he can go into his glide before he goes into his stroke, okay? I want you guys to really focus on getting a really good glide, so I want you to hold it for 1, 2, and then do your stroke, and then the frog kick, or the whip kick, okay? Does anybody have any questions before we get started with practice? No? All right, good. So first grip up. On the whistle.
Coach K, we're gonna have Landon demonstrate real quick. Landon's timing is really well, and he utilizes his legs to get himself up out of the water even more. So go ahead, Landon. Let's see you go through it real quick. See how he gets his glide at the end? So that glide stage is the key for this stroke. That's where you move forward through the water. Yeah, we got time. Go ahead.
Okay. All right, we're gonna go one more time up and back. Okay. First group up.
One thing you guys, both you guys, are really focused on is making sure you have your feet in the V.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because, like, with you were just, like, having them flat next to each other, and that's, like, keeping the V as much as for.
Okay. Okay, do your V.
Do your V.
Instead of like going to the side.
Isn't it when you're pushing back, your feet are the dorsal flex and they're gonna push back on the water.
Keep your hands cupped.
So, and that's where you really want to place.
Okay. I see when you're coming around, you're doing this. Make as if you're trying to hold water in your hands the whole time, keep it like this.
Okay.
Even on this extension here, that'll help you.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead. You can come down.
Good, Tam. How'd that feel? Better?
Good.
Peace.
Thanks, Sid.
Good, Caitlin. Oh, I just can't. You're trying to pull back.
Hi.
Yeah.
You know, made back in the
second.
Good.
Yay!
Good.
Really works.
It works.
It's okay.
It's
doing good.
Okay, we're going to move on to our last stroke, which is elementary backstroke. And in this stroke, we have the three phases. Who can tell me what happens in the first phase?
Monkey.
Good.
Airplane.
And what do you do in the monkey phase?
Bring your arms. Side.
Good. You're bringing everything up. And then what's the second phase?
Airplane.
Good. And what happens in the second phase?
Your arms go out.
And what happens with your legs?
They start to go out.
Good. And then what's the last third phase?
Soldier.
And why is that important that we make that several syllables?
So you glide.
Good, and this is the propulsion phase. And what I want you guys to try today is even extending that almost to three syllables. And sometimes you start to sink there, but see how long you can extend that to without sinking. So when your body starts to sink, then you can bring it back up to that first phase. And anything else you guys that we need to remember with this stroke? Keeping your belly button high. Good. So really quickly before we start practicing, I'm going to have Sarah Cornish do a demonstration of this stroke just up to the halfway point. So if we can all just turn our attention over to that far lane.